Historische romanschrijfster Cynthia McLeod is gisteren door de Franse ambassade uitgenodigd te vertellen over de Surinaams-Franse geschiedenis. De Franse ambassadeur in Suriname, Nicolas de la Coste, toonde zich verheugd meer hierover te weten te komen vanuit de invalshoek van de schrijfster. Volgens de la Coste probeert de ambassade altijd Surinamers te interesseren in Franse geschiedenis. Maar nu is dat omgekeerd. McLeod geeft aan dat het al te vaak voorkwam dat mensen niet wilden praten over één of meerdere voorouders uit de slavernijperiode. En na de slavernij werd er daar ook bijna nooit meer over gesproken.
We never mention slavery again. People must forget slavery. En they were successful until, let's say, 40 years ago, that the aftercomes from slaves started to want to know about their slavery past, and now it is very in. Now it is bon ton to discover. People write books. My grandmother was a slave woman, the plantation of our grandparents, and so on and so on. Now everybody thinks that when you speak about Suriname's past, you have to talk about slavery. No. Today I'm not going to speak about slavery. I'm going to speak about Suriname's past. In fact, the beginning of the Dutch colony Suriname.
McLeod vertelde verder dat het district Zeeland tijdens de slavernij op een snelle manier rijk wilde worden. Zij wilden de kolonie Suriname veroveren en over de ruggen van de Surinaamse slaafgemaakten rijk worden.
Because the colony had already sugar plantations and that's what they wanted. They wanted to be rich. But when they realized that they had to do something also, that they had to work and people had to do all kinds of things to maintain the colony, that they didn't want that. So they sold it. They sold the colony of Suriname and they sold it to the city of Amsterdam, the West Indian Company, and a very, very rich Dutchman, a nobleman, Cornelis van Aartsen van Somerset. Cornelis van Aartsen van Somerset said, then I'll go to the country and I'll be the governor. And he came to Suriname as a governor. But in the meantime, people had fled to the northern part of the French Huguenots, had fled to the northern part of Holland in the district of Friesland.
McLeod legde de aanwezigen uit dat de moeder van gouverneur van Sommelsdijk een Franse achtergrond had en dat op zo'n manier bepaalde Franse gewoonten meekwamen naar Suriname.